So I'm Sue Decker from Blue Star Farm. We are located in Stuyvesant, New York, and that's about half an hour south of Albany. We grow year round. We're in unheated tunnels, and we're also 5 acres on rented property. We're standing right now in front of our heated benches, and we run these year round. They are currently have some pepper seedlings on them right now. This is about 5 years old. So what we did is we took 2-inch foam board. We mounted a router upside down in between two tables, probably not an OSHA standard. And then we kind of set it up so it was almost like a table saw scenario where we could set it up and run it pretty much every 2 inches, put grooves in that, and then we ran that for 8-foot boards. The length of this house is 72, so minus 8 feet on both sides is the size of our benches. And then once we completed that, we put them together, it's just really kind of rail, metal poles that we constructed with and then concreted them in. And you can do this many different ways. You can't walk on top of this.
Yeah.
and sometimes I wish that we could, we would have done that a little bit differently just because I envision doing overwintering some winter radicchios and putting them in a little bit of sand on top of here and having a heated bench, and that would be really nice. So someday we might revamp. Ran the tubing. We put down some commercial sized aluminum foil to help conductivity with the heat. And then we ran the tubing down the channels and cover it with plastic to kind of save it from watering. And then we also have a capillary mat on, which we change every year. We had originally had the idea that we could actually water from the bottom all the time. So we actually set up a drip tape and sloped this slightly, but it didn't work to my satisfaction, so we don't really do that anymore. I also felt like sometimes the plants got they needed some tougher treatment. Like our brassicas were kind of wimpy, the stems were they needed that overhead watering to kind of beef them up a little bit. So
would this dry out before the
you'd have to really water a lot. And have that going for a period of time to get that uptake to be where it should be. So we have two benches like that, and that's how we start out the season. The nice thing about these benches in the early part of the season and the late part of the season, because we're pretty much year-round at this point, is that we can heat everything just on these two benches. And it can be 9 degrees outside, and as long as we're covering this with row cover, it'll stay 50 degrees in here, which saves tremendously on propane, because we don't have to heat a 30 by 72 foot house on a 9 degree night.
And this is heated by a Tagaki.
This is an on-demand.
Yep,
on-demand Tagaki system. We did try, because we have a 20K solar system here, we did try an electric water heater, but it doesn't really make sense to do it. It's really much more efficient to go with an on-demand system.
So was the electric not keeping up? Or
with the electric just costing too much.
Okay.
Yeah. We've grown since then, so we've exceeded the capacity of a 20K system, really. At least to get to net zero.
Yeah.
Occasionally, we have a month that goes to net zero. So this works really well.
Heater, and it's supporting these two benches, which are just shy of 72 feet?
Yes. They're They're about 66 feet long.
And so that one heater comes into, it looks like, two manifolds.
Yep, two manifolds, and we are able to shut this bench off and heat only this bench. So so the manifolds will come in here, so there's an outgoing and then a return. Yeah, we have a delta T, the delta T solutions.
So there's a hole of a certain size you drill in the manifold, and then these are barbed fittings that just snap in?
Yeah, or? These guys come pre-drilled. They can come pre-drilled. Okay. And then the tubing comes on a long roll, and you can roll it out for as long as you need. You know, for the investment of what I can do with these two 66-foot benches, it's not really, I mean, it totally pays for itself.